Dancing has always been a passion for me since childhood. Dancing, choreographing something or learning some choreographies, these have been my passion from the beginning. But somewhere in between, due to studies, and then I got married, and then I started work, and somewhere it got lost in between. Once I came to the UAE, then we used to have these community programs, etc. And I had a friend with whom I used to dance for these programs and all. And once we thought that we were choreographing something and we were just recording the video, and we thought, okay, it's looking nice. Why don't we just upload it on YouTube? Me and her together, we uploaded a video on YouTube, and it got a fairly good response. And I really liked this concept of making videos, because my family and friends, they were all in India. India, and they wanted to see the videos. So this putting it up on YouTube was a good idea, because at least for my close people to view, it was very nice. So that's how it started. And soon it became kind of a passion for me, creating this kind of content, making new videos and choreographing and stuff. And I couldn't continue with my friend later because we moved to a different place and all that. And that's when Ishanvi was turning 4, 5, and I was seeing that she was sharing the same passion for dance as I was. Okay, so at one point when I was choreographing something or when I was learning something, she used to try to do the steps in the same way. And my husband saw that and he said, you two should start making videos together. Really, it looks very cute when you do it. So why don't you try that? And that's when I thought of this idea. And the first video we shot, it was, we learned it together. It was just like a fun choreography, which we used to practice at home. And one day when I came home after work, we said, okay, let's record it. It was not like we planned a lot for it or anything. It was just some clothes we had, which was matching. And we just used that and we just recorded this video on the phone. I put it up on YouTube and Facebook, etc. And it got a really good response. That time we didn't have a Facebook page also. It was just on YouTube. And I think some other Facebook page had shared it. And there it went. Really, a lot of people started recognizing us. And that's when we thought, okay, so we are enjoying it. And people are enjoying watching us. So let's do more of this. And I think during the lockdown, this mom-daughter thing, it went really viral during that time. I think people were at home, kids were at home, and mothers, they were trying to engage the kids and stuff like that. So at that point, some of our videos went viral. And then now there's no looking back. So because it's something that we really enjoy doing. We have that connection through dance. Whenever we are choreographing something and we are practicing, we have a lot of fun doing it with each other. She puts her own steps and I put my steps, and together we have a lot of fun. So it's kind of, we bond through dance. It's like making content also. So that's how it goes for us. That was when Ishanvi was just 4. I just thought, let her come in for a small portion of a dance. I was making a patriotic dance, and I just brought her together for maybe 30 seconds or something. But people really enjoyed watching her. And it was a patriotic song and a mother-daughter bond. And that feeling people really loved. Yeah, there are some really lucky people who have that one video which goes viral and they get a lot of followers and suddenly they rise to fame. But in reality, that's not always the case, because when we put up Jaga Hindustan, it was moderate, because reaching people is important. Maybe your content is really good, but is it really reaching people? This is important. Okay, and when we put up Kudiyeni is our first dance which people really enjoyed, which on Facebook, on some page, it went viral and people didn't know who we were. Mm-hmm. Okay, so on YouTube, on our YouTube channel, it was not getting a lot of views. And that's when we felt, okay, it's not reaching people, but there's nothing much you can do about it. some people say that you need that one video. Yeah, but for that one video, there's a lot of work behind it. And okay, what after that one video? Okay, you have that one video, and then people are expecting a lot from you. This is what happens to always. People are expecting better from you, not something below what you did before. Yeah, it's like this. Yeah. I work 6 days in a week, so I get only one day as a weekend. And she goes to school and I have to match it with her school hours when I get time with her to practice. So there are a lot of things involved. Usually, on an average, we release 2 videos a month or maybe maximum 3, like 2, one mom daughter and 2 solos of her, or 2 mom daughter and 1 solo of her, something like this. This is what we do. So on an average, it takes 7 days to 10 days, sometimes 14 days for one video, based on so many things, because it's about choreographing it, which I do alone. So I can take my time. I mean, I can do it whenever I can, but practicing, both of us need to be together. So practicing takes time, and costumes. The costumes are another thing. We have to design the costume, go get them stitched and see if they are looking okay. And then shooting also, because I get one Friday, I mean, Friday is off for me. So maybe if you're shooting outside and maybe it's very cloudy that day, or it's there's a sandstorm or something, so that Friday is gone. So I have to move to the next Friday. It's like this. So it's not really easy. It takes a lot of time mostly. Time is a big issue for me, for editing, for designing everything. Yeah, but you know, when something is your passion, you somehow take out time for it. I don't feel like, okay, that I have work and this is another work. I don't feel like that. This is something which I really enjoy. So that's how I do it.
Yeah, I am also happy because I am also meeting other people. All the dance forms I know.
Okay, which is the best one you like? No, best one.
I don't know.
You don't know? She likes Bharatanatyam one day and she likes Kathak another day. And it depends on who her friends in class are, or if the teacher said she was doing very well. If the teacher says she's doing very well, she loves that dance form. Maybe if they tell, okay, this is a mistake, she doesn't like it so much. So it depends on a lot of things. She used to enjoy dancing from a very long time, especially like when she was around like 2 or 3 years old. Like whenever we used to go for long drives and all, she used to enjoy the song and she used to make her own steps for it and everything. But I put her, yeah, at 4 years of age, I put her for classes. I have learned a bit of Bharatanatyam when I was younger, but not so much. So I'm not professionally trained as such. So I wanted her to learn from proper teachers. So I put her for classes when she was 4. Before that, when she was around 3, she used to dance a lot, and she has performed in some stage programs over here, just because her friends were performing and she really wanted to do it, and that was the motivation for her. Like, I want to be on stage. This was her thing. Even now it's like that. She loves being on stage. Like, me and her father were okay, we are nervous about it, but she really enjoys the attention. So it's always been like that. But I felt her concentration span was a little less when she was like 3 and all. So I put her for classes when I thought that was okay, around 4. So she's been learning from teachers. Yeah, I have not trained her as such. In the sense, whatever Bollywood I know, because it has no set rules. Bollywood is like, yeah. And other classical dance forms she's learning outside. I'm an orthodontist. I'm a dental braces specialist. Yeah. So it is not hectic as a as hectic as a medical profession for me. Dental is a bit easier, but it is, the number of hours are there. So you have to go to work, you have to cover those hours. Mm. These things are there, but I manage because I have a good work atmosphere, that's all. I have good supportive colleagues, and more than anything, I don't get anything back home. Like, once I finish work, I don't come home and think about, okay, what has happened at work. I leave it there. Okay, so whatever is there is sorted the next day at work. So I don't bring home all those things. The stress of work, I don't bring it home, because when I come back from work, I concentrate on my family, my daughter, and maybe the dances and everything. And yeah, time, as I said, it is a hassle for me. But I manage, because see, content creation for me is a hobby, and there is no deadline for me. Okay, I have to do this video this day. I don't have this deadline, so I can do when I want. I know that the people are expecting. Okay, I keep getting messages on YouTube also. We love this channel, but then you put videos late. Why don't you put videos every week? I get this sort of messages, but there is. I have my limitations, so I take it easy. And sometimes I do say it takes some time, maybe from 2 weeks it goes to 3 weeks sometimes for creating a video. Yeah, that's how it is. Yeah, the 100 million is, you know, it's difficult for me to digest sometimes also. I think that it's, I'm like, okay, it's 100 million. I'm not able to believe it too sometimes. But I don't know, somehow I feel that, I don't feel that way. Like you said, you're an online celebrity. I really don't feel that. I'm just a mom who is sharing a passion with my daughter. That's it. And a lot of people are viewing our video. I think they are connecting through the dance in it. They like to see Ishanvi, and they like to dance with their kids like that. Or the kids see Ishanvi and they want to dance like that. And it's a beautiful thing. For me, the number of views, of course, when our first video was reaching 500k and 600k, I looked at it and I told my husband, yes, I want it to reach 1 million. Will it reach 1 million? This is what I said. Yeah. And now it's at 100 million. So it's like a dream. But I don't let it get to me, really. I have some very close friends, like very few, but some of them used to tell me that, your content is really good. Maybe one day you'll reach 1 million followers. There were people telling this to me, but I never took it like really seriously and gave a serious thought about it. It was just doing what we like, and I'm really grateful. I'm really grateful that we have reached whatever we have reached. I don't consider it as a big thing, really. Maybe it's our content, maybe it's luck, or maybe there are different things. Okay, so 100 million is okay. What I like the most is a lot of people got inspired by it. We got a lot of covers of our videos, a lot of mothers dancing with their kids, daughter-in-laws dancing with their mother-in-laws, and grown-up daughters dancing with their mothers. It's lovely to see all this. And that's what, regarding the fame and the explosion and everything, I really don't let it get to me, because things can change, you know. I mean, maybe now they love it because Ishani is younger and you see the small kid and the mother dancing, so they love it. Maybe after 5 years, they don't enjoy it so much because she's grown up. Maybe. I'm just thinking of it. Yeah. So I don't want to let it get to me. So I'm working more on how we are growing with it, like especially for Ishanvi. I want her to be better every day. I try to get her trained very well, try to do different things for her so that her passion is nurtured. Other than that, I don't think too much about it, because I have seen this. Some videos go viral and then you don't see them again. You don't know where they are. It's like, so I think it's a temporary thing, or I would definitely like this to be long term, but I don't want to have too much expectations from it also. I usually keep smaller goals. okay, like, okay, what's going to be my next video? What am I planning? What, this is it. Okay, I don't think too much about, okay, how, where I want to reach. This is not what I think. For Ishanvi, yeah, obviously, as a parent, as a mother, I have big dreams for her. Okay, that she should, especially with regard to classical dance, I want her to really study it well. Because at this point, no, it's very important for the next generation to bring our culture forward. This is what Absolutely. I feel. So I don't want her to get lost in just Bollywood and people. Obviously, Bollywood is something I really love and the whole world loves. But there is this beautiful Indian classical dance forms which I want her to learn, and I want her to like as a kid to bring it up to her generation. Because I see a lot of kids, what I see nowadays is mainly in reality shows, the kids are doing stunts and stuff and there's gymnastics and everything. Obviously, that is also an art form, the beautiful Indian classical art form, or be it Bollywood for that matter. Somewhere in between, it is disappearing in their generation. This is what right. I see. So I want her to go ahead with that. This is my, this is what I see for her. See, because I am working and I'm pursuing both, it is difficult for me to have big plans, though I would like to, like maybe in the future I would like to conduct some classes or workshops, especially for kids who cannot, who are not, to whom these dance classes are difficult to access. When I see our videos, we have messages from many, many parts of India. The kids are saying, Didi, we see your dance, and from that dance I learned, and then I performed in my brother's wedding, and they send us videos. They, in the rural parts of India also, they are doing the same dance because they don't go to classes. So they look at the videos and they try to learn. If possible, I would really love to conduct some classes for these kids or make some tutorials for them, so that all of them, they have the passion for dance, so maybe something they can learn from. So YouTube is a good thing. So they don't have to pay for the classes. They just have to look at the videos and they have to learn. Other than dance, I don't think there is much we can do. I mean, really, we are good at that. I don't want to like just get into something just because a lot of people tell us, okay, now you're getting popular. Why don't you try this? Why don't you try that? I'm like, no. See, it's like we are popular for dance. Popular is a big word, but we are known for dance. Okay, so yes. If I go and try to do something else for people just because now they are following us, I don't think they will like it so much, really. So I would like to stick to dance itself. But like I said, maybe try with some tutorials or something, some tips about dance and all these, maybe I will try to do in the future. Even when TikTok came, we were not on TikTok. We joined TikTok, I think one video or something we put, but then we didn't go ahead with it because we really cannot afford to do 10 videos per day. We don't have the time for it. Okay, and for me, what I feel is when I make content, I really make sure that there's something nice in it, like something special in it. There have been times when I shot a video and I was not very happy with it, and I have like cancelled uploading it, or I have redone it and stuff. So I really give a lot of importance to the quality of the content. So I would not like to venture into everything and try everything and give average content. No, that's not something I would want to do. That's why I make sure that sometimes even I think, why am I thinking so much? Like to put up one video, I think so much. I'm sending it to my mom, I'm sending it to my friend. Is it looking okay? I think a lot of it. But I think one way it's good because it I can see the quality, whether it's good, whether it's enough. So this is my idea. So I don't want to venture into everything and try everything. But in the future, maybe if I can make a channel for tutorials or for tips on dance or something like this, as I learn, I can share my experiences with people. Maybe, yes. The because even on YouTube, when I upload content, it's like Bollywood most of the time. But in between, I feel, okay, let's put a Bharatanatyam piece of Ishanvi, or maybe let's put a Kathak thing of Ishanvi. I see that YouTube immediately, I put the content and my YouTube analytics tells me, okay, people are not viewing this video as much as they view your other videos. It gives me the feedback. It tells me that, okay, people, when we recommend this video, people are not viewing it, or even if they view it, they're not viewing it for long. This is what YouTube tells me. It's just analyzing. But when I see it, I'll be like, okay, people are not enjoying this content so much, maybe because it's a classical piece, but that will not stop me from uploading. What's happening is there are kids who are watching our Bollywood videos, and since they are following our channel, they are forced to watch the classical also. They see how it works, they see especially a Krishna dance of Ishanvi, which I uploaded last time. A lot of kids loved it. Okay, because she was Krishna at one point, she was Radha at one point. They loved seeing how it works. You know, it's like we are giving importance to our culture. And maybe one or two videos don't go very well in the channel just because they are classical. But on the whole, this is going to reach people. This is what my idea is. And more than views and more than popularity of the channel, this matters a lot to me. With regard to Ishanvi and with regard to Indian culture, this is something I really believe in. So this is how it goes for me. I mean, directly there, nobody has approached us for something. There have been some people have shared our videos, some good choreographers and some other celebrities. Like maybe when we do it on a song, maybe the singer of the song or the actors of the song, some of them have shared our content on their Instagram stories and everything. And last time we had Shashi Tharoor sir tweeting Ishanvi's video, asking people to watch it. Yeah, so like this, we have not directly connected with people like this. But we have seen them sharing our content elsewhere, and that's a very nice thing. We really, it's overwhelming to see that, okay, people are recognizing us. Okay, people really saw us doing this. Yeah. So there have been instances like this, but directly, no. There have, for reality shows, yes. A lot of reality shows have approached us, and I'm still not sure about that, whether I should go or send Ishanvi for that. So those things have happened, but that's it. Before COVID, like all of us, we were also very carefree, and we thought, okay, the world is beautiful, let's travel, let's do this, let's do that, like everybody else. And when COVID hit, all of us, I think, reality really stuck, you know, struck us. We know that, okay, anything can happen anytime. It's really scary, especially because you have a child. You keep thinking, okay, is she going to have a childhood like us? Is she going to have a normal childhood? Is she going to meet people again? What is going to happen? It was very stressful. Yeah. So, yeah, work got affected. But I think like everybody else, even we got a lot of family time together, especially with our kids and stuff. I don't know. I think most of us were privileged enough to have enough to support ourselves during that time. Yeah, there have been people on whom the effect was really harsh and bad. So now it's the things have come back to almost normal. But yeah, we have learned our lessons, I think. It's important to not overdo things. Even in India, the situation is almost gone back to normal now. Yes. Yeah, but the impact is still there. We can still see the impact of the COVID. I think it will take some time for this to go. And suddenly you realize that all those things doesn't matter at all. What matters is how healthy you are and how safe you are. This is what matters. This is what COVID has taught all of us. Yeah, that time we got a lot of time for this. Because I was working half. I was working 3 days a week. And I got a lot of time with her. She had no school or maybe half day online school. So we had a lot of time together. We explored a lot. We danced together, and a lot of people were online at that time. And that was right. one time where, okay, when our content reached a lot of people, because everybody was free and everybody was watching things online, and the amount of engagement we got at that time was very good. We got great engagement from people during that time. The same thing now, it is a little less because people are busy in their world again. But that time, I think for all content creators, it was a great time to grow.
True.
I mean, there was the stress of the COVID, obviously. But other than that, and everything became online and simpler. Like for dance classes also, before the COVID, we used to travel like 30 minutes one way for the classes for Ishanvi, because we stay in the outskirts. But now everything is online. I know it's sometimes not the same because she's missing her friends in class and everything, but it became simpler. And because of this, a lot of online classes are accessible to everybody now. Maybe we can, in the future, I mean, now already classes are online. So you can take classes from India also now, even though you are abroad. It's like this. A lot of things changed.
I want to become a Kathak dancer, a Bharatanatyam dancer, and a doctor.
And a doctor. Oh my god.
Oh, wow.
Three things. It used to be two, right? Now it turned to three.
A doctor.
What kind of doctor? Like a doctor who treats animals, or a doctor for the heart? Or,
doctor for animals.
A doctor for animals. She loves animals. There's no question, it's me.
It's what the one.
You don't know how competitive she is. Interesting thing about us that nobody else knows.
We play together.
We play together, okay. That's
then
a
we
very...
read books together.
Yeah. We read a lot of books together, yeah. Ishanvi loves reading books, and now she's writing books also.
Once I hear like some good music, like Liggy, when I first heard it, we remember we both heard it, and we after doing one dance, we just put one celebration small thing and we heard this song. It is so beautiful.
Good music inspires her. Nice song. Let's dance on this. Yeah, this is what happened with our latest video, Liggy. We really loved that song, and though it was not very popular, we decided to go ahead and do it because she really loved that song. And one more thing is, when people appreciate her, that inspires her. She really likes it and she wants to do more. Correct?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Liggy and Ghagra.
Liggy. Ghagra is always the favorite. And now it's Liggy. Right?
Yeah, because it's very playful also.
Playful? Okay.
We went to the beach.
Okay. She liked it. She likes it because we went to the beach to shoot a part of it. And she loved the beach. And she loves the song. And she loves the beach. And yeah, that's enough.
For we went everywhere around the world.
Correct. Around the world. It was just Abu Dhabi. Anyway. I think... What, you would like to say something?
Yes.
Oh, okay then. What's the tip you want to give?
We will dance and make good videos that will help the other people to know. Like, we do...
To learn.
We do tutorials.
Tutorials, okay.
We do some lives also sometimes and we perform there. That helps.
Okay, what he's asking is, what tips you would like to give? Okay, tips means how like what advice you would like to give. One tip Ishanvi would like to give is, you need to practice. Right? Yeah, because practice makes?
Perfect.
Practice makes perfect.
Perfect.
Yeah, because one tip I, what I would like to say to people who would like to pursue dance is, there are many people who ask me, ma'am, what dance form should I start? Okay, this is your personal thing. Okay, if you enjoy it, then definitely you will really do well in it, because you have that motivation to do it. This is what I feel. More than anything, you should be enjoying it. And there are some parents who ask me, ma'am, I want my daughter to dance like your daughter. What should I do? See, this is not the thing, really. This maybe for Ishanvi, dance is a passion. Maybe for your child, there is some other passion. Maybe he enjoys writing or playing the piano, or maybe just cooking, or maybe his talent lies somewhere else. So don't just impose something on your child, because some of them even tell me, I take them for classes, but it's difficult to make them like motivated for that. That's because they're not enjoying it so much. And the moment you put in more on them, like you have to do it, they will find it. I think it's important for mothers to look at, to identify what your kid's passion is, and then to nurture that passion. I think this is very important. And if your kid is interested in dance, what I would like to say is definitely you need to give them good training, okay?
Yeah.
You need to put them for proper classes if you want them to do a particular dance form. All this is very important. And obviously, practicing is very important, because for some people, dancing might be easy. And for some people, dancing might be very interesting, but it might not be so easy. This is important.
Right.
And one more thing is that some kids, they even at ages 3, etc., they have good coordination skills. They're able to dance well. But some kids, they are able to dance well when they are older. Like, for example, when I was very, maybe when I was 4 or 5 or 6, like Ishanvi, I couldn't dance so well. I mean, not that I'm a great dancer now, but I developed that coordination and that interest, and that I could dance properly only when I was like maybe 8 or 9 years old. It's like this. So for different people, it's at different ages. So just because your child is 6 and another kid of 8-6 is dancing very well, don't force your kid to dance like her. Maybe she will dance like that when she's 8. It's like this.
Yeah.
This is what I've seen in the dance classes also. Some kids, even at a smaller age, they have good stability, they have good balance, they have good hand eye coordination, etc. But some kids develop that late. And I think it's very important to for the parent to understand this. Otherwise, your kid is going to get tired by the time she's 8 or 9, because you are imposing so much on her. Maybe she will be tired. It's like this. So this is important. Other than that, yeah, that's it. So you basically need to enjoy it, and then everything will fall in place. Yes.
When I am bigger, like what you said, no? If I could not dance at this age, I will try to do it when I'm 8.
Ah, okay. Now you're going to tell me you'll do it at 8. Okay. See, first thing I would like to tell, when you think about content creation, okay, first you need to think if your content is good enough that you want to show it to people. Okay, and once you know that it is, first we need to work on that, what kind of content we want to create, and if the content is good enough. Okay, if you think it's not good enough, work on it, make it better, make it reach a phase where, okay, show it to your family and friends. Do they think it's really nice, really entertaining, or really, okay, there's a message in it or something like this? Make your content good, first of all. Once your content is good, immediately you will have the confidence to bring it in front of the world. That is what I would like to say. When you face the camera, you know your dance is good. You know the song is something which people will enjoy. You know you are not doing something out of your comfort zone. Do what you are comfortable with. Do what you like. Don't think, okay, people are asking me to do this, so let me try this. Don't do that, okay? Because for me personally, we get a lot of song requests. For example, last time we got a lot of song requests on the song Genda Phool. Okay, so this is what I believe in. Just because people want me to do something, I will not do it. Okay, I will do it if I think, if it matches my set of what I have these beliefs, and if it matches with that, I'm going to do it. I think this is very important. Be comfortable with what you are doing. Make a set of rules you are going to follow, and you don't have to break those rules for anybody. This is what is important. And one more thing you need to think is, don't think about, okay, I'm going to make this content. I have had people asking me, okay, so you're getting copyrights on your songs, so you're not making money out of this video, still why are you doing it? Don't think about monetizing financial thing in the beginning. What you think about is how good your content is and how you can grow with it. This is very important. This is what I feel first. In the beginning, you think about, okay, I'm going to make this kind of content because this is going to bring this kind of money. It does not work like that. First, you make content to reach people. Then you know, okay, what you can do for your financial aspects or whatever. This is how it goes. This is what I believe in. I know there are different people having their ways, but this is just my way and this is what I would like to tell you. I think one myth is that people think it's very easy. They think it's really easy. They think, okay, you know to dance, it's very easy to, okay, to make a video and to put it up and okay, since you're a good dancer. See, being a good dancer and being a good content creator are not, are two different things. Okay, I have seen some very good dancers doing very good, like on the stage, but the videos, when they, maybe when they make content, it's not reaching so much people. So it's two different things. So people think that it's very easy for a dancer to be a content creator. That is a myth. That's really a myth. A content creator, and it's not that somebody will teach you how to be a content creator. A content creation is something you will learn by doing. And you cannot do what others are doing. I mean, to an extent, yes. But if you just try to do what exactly that person is doing, then it is of no use. It's just like, okay, there's a brand and there is a brand which is copying it. It's like that. So this is what I think. So it is not easy. So people who think that is easy and the people who are just trying to put up videos everywhere, just make a video. No, it's not so easy. You need to plan properly about it. You need to see the quality of the content. So this is what I would like to tell you. This is a myth that it is very easy. It is really not easy. There's a lot of hard work behind it. They say, okay, mother and daughter, very cute. It's viral. And oh, so nice. It suddenly got viral. No, but there is a lot of work behind it. I get a lot of messages on Instagram. Basically, that's where people connect with me. I try to, though it's not possible to message all the time, I try my best to go through my messages and respond whenever possible. So Instagram is a way people can approach me. Also, we have a website which we have opened recently, which is www.lasyadance.com. And there's a contact form there, so people can approach us there also, and we will try our best to respond to people. Facebook Messenger, my inbox is full, I cannot really go through it. Yeah, so Facebook Messenger, I've not been opening so much. But Instagram and our website, people can reach us. First of all, I don't know if we can really bring a huge impact on the world, really. I don't know if we are big enough for that. But that being said, every small thing, even a small thing can make a big difference in the world. I know that. Yeah. So if you ask me what impact, like I already told you regarding Indian classical dance and Indian culture, I would like the next generation, Ishanvi's generation, to be familiar with it. If not well versed with it, they should be at least familiar with it. They should know our culture. They should be proud of it. And they should feel like learning it and spreading it to the world. This is what I want to do. This is what I'm working on. Other than that, I would also want a lot of mothers to pursue their passion with their kids. Because when you become a mother and suddenly you get very busy, maybe you're a working woman or you're at home, whatever it is, you are very busy. You are very busy managing so many things that you forget your passions. You forget, you sacrifice everything for your family. And it becomes monotonous. So this is what I would like to tell all the mothers. To pursue their passion as much as possible. To find themselves, if possible, with their kids. It would be lovely. Yeah, this is what I would like to. This is the change I would like to bring. if we can.